Hello, hi, and welcome to yet another episode of Candid with Candida. इष्टानो जायत्या कोकणी माचयेच्या कलाकारांक जावं माचयेवेल्या कलाकारांक आमी तुमकां मेळयल्यात. बट नाव इट्स टायम टू से हाय फॉर डी जेज अगेन. येस, द बेस्ट पार्ट ऑफ बिंग अ डी जे इज टू मेक पीपल हॅपी, अँड इट इन्क्लूड्स अ लॉट ऑफ हार्डशिप्स, लॉट ऑफ स्ट्रगल, लॉट ऑफ सॅक्रिफायसेस, अँड ऑफकोर्स स्लीपलेस नाईट्स, विच आउटरेजेस, अँड द आउटकम इज अ सक्सेसफुल डी जे ॲट द एंड. So please welcome the two DJs in the house, DJ Jonathan Barreto along with Ellen D'Souza, aka DJ Skeletron. Yoka dumkam cheka
Javelin.
Welcome on my show. So how are you all doing?
All good.
Yeah.
Good, good.
Good.
Okay. So DJ in sort busy ha.
Sada chalte.
Tu vacationer ha. Oh, let me tell you that DJ Jonathan is all the way from UK. Born in Goa, but is working in UK, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Skeletron, so let me start with you. One of your remix, that is of the movie album Gehraiyan, it's an official music album over there. So, and I don't know what was the secret behind it. How did you end up doing it? So, can you tell us the story?
So this was last year actually. So Deepika Padukone had posted one story with that the title song Gehraiyan. So and it was not released that time, so it was unreleased. So and I was like browsing, like I was searching for this song on YouTube, and I couldn't found it because it was unreleased. So I thought of, you know, like remixing and, you know, just doing it for fun, you know, just putting out there. So I remixed it and I put it on my social media, Instagram. I made it as a reel, and yeah, and it had like only 300 views that time.
Okay.
And I think I was like lucky enough that the director Shakun Batra and Ankur Tiwari, they were both sitting and they were like browsing on their phone, like they were just checking reels, I don't know what. So they found my reel. Okay. And Ankur Tiwari, he's the music director of that album. So he really liked it, and then he told Sony to, you know, like, we need to get this boy on board.
Okay.
So he pitched my remix to Sony Music, and Sony Music got in touch and they signed it officially. So that's how it happened.
You just made it for fun's sake, again.
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
You didn't have any intention where would it end up?
Yeah, yeah. There was no connection, no Bollywood connection, nothing. I made it as a reel.
And what was the age that time for you? Were you young?
No, like I'm 29 by the way, I don't look like
but yeah. What was the age when you did that?
28.
Okay,
last
recently.
Year, yeah, last year it was.
So how did you feel?
I was like at cloud nine, you know, all this the actor Siddhant Chaturvedi, like he used that song so many times in his stories. He tagged me also, like he was shooting some Big Boss finale.
Okay.
So he was going with his bike and he put my music in the background and he tagged me. So that was amazing.
Okay. But you know, the best part is if you hear the original one, it's a little bit slower.
Yeah,
so why did you choose like giving it a peppy tune or something like that?
Yeah, because I felt like, okay, the vocals, the lyrics, they were on point, but when the main chorus comes, it's not hitting you. So I thought of, you know, like putting my chorus instead of the original chorus, and that's how it worked, you know, like it actually goes well with the reels. Like, you know, people used my remix you know, in such a way that, you know, they can edit pictures and edit videos. Like, it's like 1 second videos they were doing on that remix.
Okay, what do you do now currently?
Now I do DJing. I make my music. I've started my another project called Aka, wherein I wear mask and make music and shoot videos. And recently I've opened my music academy.
Wow,
Skeletron Academy. Yeah. So I teach DJing, music production, mixing and mastering.
All right.
Yeah. Okay. Recently, I've started.
That's really very nice. All the very best to your future endeavors and whatever your incomings are.
Thank you.
Moving on to Jonathan. Jonathan, DJ Jonathan Munta. Then I'm zaiti theatre cha banner rehta. Like, we get the posters. And on that poster, they, of course, there are other DJs, but one name that we, you know the reporter there, DJ Jonathan Barreto. So, did you always want to be a DJ like Poilens and Moti Nahle, or it happened just when you went UK?
No, because like after my graduation, so I was into like 2 months what to do, because I had done my graduation in major in history and geography. So then, I was just thinking like, what's next? So then it came to my mind like, once I was seeing a bartending video, a flair bartender.
Okay.
So I said, okay, fine, let's try this. Then I went, I did my course, learned flaring, and then started working as a flair bartender. And I was working in Sapphires as a flair bartender. And then from there, like, I went to Cape Town Cafe, which is in Baga. So over there, then I used to see like many Agowan DJs who used to come play. So looking at them, and you know, it inspired me, like why don't I give a try to become a DJ? So then I said, okay, fine. The next step, like I'll just try. And then I did my DJ course. And then within that year, like I happened to go to the UK. So I said, nah, I'm new to this country. I have no friends, none, nothing. Just all by myself. So then once like there was a party which was hosted by Impact Events, and Somesh, I happened to call him.
You are associated to
Yeah, I'm now first I started with him as a DJ, and now like after long years, now I'm the manager for that the Impact Events club, the organization. And like so even he pushed me, and then you know, through my hard work and dedication, and so that is how like I'm just growing myself. And then even like in the UK, I met another friend who was into Bollywood. So I play even Bollywood, Bhangra, all type of music. Like, so you tell me to play anything, I can do it anything. Yeah.
Okay, when it comes to music, you all just go crazy.
Yeah.
Okay, tell me something. How did you all come in contact with each other?
So basically he got in touch with me, so he wanted to learn music production. So he got in touch with me, and we did a online course.
Okay, you all both did it together?
No, like I was learning from him, so he taught me, like, because like just staying as a DJ, you know, can't help me to grow. Because if I have to achieve something, even I should learn like music production and all, which he taught me. And due to tight schedule in the UK, and no, I don't get time to practice. But still, here and there, like when I get time, I just whatever he has taught me, I just put into practice. And then now let's see how where I go from a bartender, I become a DJ. So from a DJ, now let's see if I be a music producer.
All right, okay, that is his story. So tell me from your side, what was your childhood? Did you always want to be a DJ, or did it happen by fluke, or how it was?
Yeah, see, when I was a kid, I always loved music. Okay, but like during school days, I was like fond of playing football. So I used to play for my school, and then after my SSC, I got a computer, and then one of my friend, he introduced me this software called FL Studio.
Okay.
So I was just like trying out, you know, what is this, and you know, I was like, this felt like a video game to me. So I got so engrossed in that, and you know, from there onwards, like I never looked back. So I started working a lot. Like, I was too addicted.
Okay.
So I used to come home from my college, have food, and then you
know. What was the family support that you got that time?
Yeah, my mother used to support me. My father didn't. You know, like every other Indian parents, they don't support this field. So, but now I'm doing good. So both of them, they support me now. So yeah, and that's. It took me a lot of time, because that time internet was not a big thing. So I had to learn by myself, like at least 60% I learned on my own. Then when internet came in, YouTube came in, then that's how I, you know, try to explore over there, you know, how this is done basically
the
professionally.
Changing technology. Yeah. Okay. Jonathan, tujhe murge par how it was? Was it like police and dabe dadaitalo, or it changed, or how it was?
For me, like from childhood, like how you said, even I was into music. Music in the sense, like whenever there used to be some songs, and I used to always dance, and then even play football and all. and then it happened like I wanted to be a drummer. And a drum. So you know, my dad like he purchased a drum set, and then at home like we just play drumming and here and there. And then like because when my dad saw me like, you know, I had that like a passion to play drum and all, so he told me like, why don't you, you know, learn drumming, you know. I said okay, fine. So then he told me. And then what happened, like he took me to Chris Perry's son, Glenn Perry.
Okay.
And then over there, Glenn Perry told me like he gave me some beats, and then I was just drumming and all. Then he said, okay, fine. From tomorrow, come to me with a book and a pen, and then I'll teach you notes and all. So, no, it was something different. So I said, learning notes, because that time I was small. So I said, forget it. So I did not go only. But now, till today, I repent, like my dad gave
why
me a push and why I did not learn. If I would learn
so
that...
So now you said you are a DJ and at Fudem again my
sister... music production. Yeah. So I was supposed to poilo shiklo jale music production. Makao, like I would be like called as a DJ, as a music producer.
So you all had family support?
Yeah, family support.
Till
like
now,
my mom,
anybody in your family is a musician?
No one.
No keen interest. You? Nothing.
No one.
Okay. DJs are never meant to stay so quiet. Why are y'all so quiet? Okay, no. When y'all were young, were y'all there banging the boxes and all that?
Yeah, utensils, as you said, okay. I used to do that.
Was it?
Yeah.
Then mama used to paste you?
No. She used to support.
Okay. Yeah. Dad used to.
Dad, he was.
Alright, okay. There's always this thing in mind, and I need your opinion on that. In India, there are two industries. One is of EDM. And the other one is Bollywood DJ industry. So it's always seen that it's not going parallel. Mm-hmm. There is something or the other, which is, I don't know, why is it happening? It is that, you know, when EDM music is there, EDM DJ industry, some music festival is there that time, this Bollywood DJ DJs are not allowed to play that music. And the other one is vice versa. So why is it happening? What do you think? Anyways, they both can manage, even as he said, EDM and Bollywood, he can play. But still, there is something which is keeping them behind. What is your opinion? What are your takes on it?
It's like because it's each one's mentality, like how we take it. Because in music doesn't have any language. It's universal. And dusre mota mota like te namge thinking te. You can mix any song into any like any genre, like whether it's Bollywood, whether it's Punjabi, Bangla, or anything. So, but I don't feel like it should make a difference.
What about you?
I think there are.
Is it happening or what is the current scenario?
Yeah, that Bollywood DJs are not allowed to play for EDM festivals. It's true. I think it's because you know there is something called as copyright. So if you play music like. Let's say I'm performing at Sunburn. They strictly told me, like I played it last year. They strictly told me not to play Bollywood because it's not allowed. Because the record labels like T-Series and you know Sony, they don't allow. If you play, they will fine.
Okay.
Like fine will be off like 3 lakhs, 4 lakhs, like that it is.
Okay.
Yeah, so maybe that's the reason they don't allow Bollywood.
But is it
DJs.
Okay or what it is according to you?
Yeah, but there are some parties happening where they allow Bollywood music.
Okay, as far as DJ is okay with it, then I think
yeah,
that
yeah, in clubs
problem.
And all it's allowed, but festivals like Sunburn and all, like
okay,
yeah, it's not
now. According to me, 10 years back, y'all started this career, and when y'all started this career, did y'all have this thing in mind that DJ would go ahead, or what was the thing? What was the scenario at that time? Like, what was the people's mentality over there?
Yeah, when I started that time, it was not there. Like, you know, in Goa, there were like, you can say, six to eight DJs that time, 10 years back, like who were like doing really good. Now, if you go to see, there will be more than 100 DJs.
Okay, so DJs are doing very well.
Yeah.
What is the difference that you see in Goa and in UK when you go to play?
Goa and UK, there's a lot of difference because Tingasur kiti ata. There are a lot of communities. I mean, Goenkarangali, I got Hyderabadi, Punjabi. So, they sogale apnange je community, they try to promote. So, Tingasur, Satami, Sada Goenkar Munan. सो वी हैव टू प्रमोट आवर कम्युनिटी सो आम्ही थिंग असं चोरचे जेना आम्ही पार्टीज बघत आहे सो वी मेक इट अ पॉइंट लाईक आम्ही थिंग असर कोंकणी कातरां घालूंकच जाय आम्ही सो वेदर इट्स एनी फेस्ट खंयचे फेस्टिवल जावं तें सो आम्ही कोंकणी कातरां घालता थिंग आम्ही आनी दुसरें म्हणटा तें की डीजेज आनी हें तें सो पयलें वेन आय वेंट ओवर तें सो म्हाका म्हणजे दिसनालें की कितें जातलें म्हण थिंग असर सो आय वॉज लायक ऑलवेज थिंकींग हाव टू डू इट हाव टू डू इट सो लायक एज आय सेड बिफोर लायक आय मेट सोमेश एन्ड देन थ्रू हीम लायक आय हॅव कम सच अ लाँग वे सो आय एम ऑलवेज थँक्यूफूल टू हीम आनी
दे इवन कॉल मी टू यू के टू परफॉर्म Yeah, so last month I went to UK and performed.
Okay, so this, yeah, this. What was the difference? Like, how? What is the feeling?
It's really good, you know, like the energy, you know, our Goans, you know, they are like more energetic over there than here. So that energy, that vibe I felt, you know. But these boys are like
all positive vibes.
Yeah. He and Somesh, they are like doing really good job in.
Okay, what are the things that you all organize over there?
Like many parties, whatever festivals we have here, like Sanjaan Jao, Christmas, New Year, and Easter.
The Goa Day, are you a part of Goa Day?
Yeah, Goa Day, there was a Goan community who used to like organize Goa Day for many years. And because of COVID and all, so everything was stopped. So this year they kept it at hold. And then last year, what happened, like, एवरीवन ऑल द अदर कम्युनिटीज इन इन द यू के थिंगा सगळे आपणागे फेस्टिवल बघताले सो लायक माय सेल्फ सोमेश आणि कॅल्विन सो आम्ही म्हणजे बसून आले सो आम्ही किती म्हणणार रे ह्या वर्षा गोवा डे ना सो आम्ही किती केलं लायक ओके बरं चल वी थ्री ऑफ अस लायक गॉट टुगेदर आणि कोरिया मग सांगले सो दिस इज हाव लायक ते ना वी कॉल्ड इट वी कॉल इट एज अ गोवन फियेस्ता
गोवन
फिजिया So, but like आता पण because last year when we did it, like we got a good response, and it was more than almost 30,000 people like Goans came in.
Okay.
Goans and there were a few other community guys also. So now this year like
there are plans.
Yeah, we have got plans and we are doing something different only. And then we'll do something big. So let's see.
Yeah, thank you so much. Good luck for your future endeavors. Thank you. The other thing, what is the current scenario that you see when it comes to DJ? Is it definitely is it it's blooming because of the I think high rates of the bands? So what do you have to say on that? Is it a question mark or what do you have to say?
Yeah, it's about like.
What do people prefer more?
See, some nowadays what I've seen is people book band also and DJ also for weddings. So band, you know, they'll do their slow set and fast set DJs will do. So this is how it's going. Like, you know, some people they go for only DJs because DJs, you know, they come cheaper like compared to bands.
Okay, all right. Okay, well done. And all my questions you all have answered. So now it's time to play rapid fire round. So are you ready
sure.
for it?
Yes.
Sure.
Okay.
Let's do it.
All right, rapid fire round with DJ Skeletron. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay. Exciting thing in your life right now?
My academy.
Okay. Best thing of being a DJ?
You can make people smile.
Okay.
Happy.
Worst thing of being a DJ?
The requests.
Okay. Something that always be with you when you travel?
My phone.
Okay. A book you love?
I don't read books.
Okay. Instagram or Twitter?
Instagram.
Song that always make you dance?
My own song, Basanti.
Okay. Most memorable show you played?
I think it has to be there are many actually, but I would prefer the London show which I did recently.
Okay, are you just saying it because he is there?
No,
genuinely.
No, genuinely.
All right.
I love the energy over there.
Most memorable show you saw?
Memorable show
that you saw?
I think it was Sunburn.
Okay, what would you say is the most rewarding part of being a DJ?
Money.
Okay. Okay. Who is your best DJ?
Best DJ from Goa.
Anywhere.
I would say Kashmir.
Okay. Who is your best music producer?
David Guetta.
Which is your key song?
Gehraya, my own song.
Okay. Who can be your partner all the time?
Partner, I'm not a good person to work with. I don't gel well.
Okay. You so and you.
I'm, yeah.
Only you.
Yeah, only
okay.
me.
Okay. When is the time that you're sad?
When I don't have any work.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah.
Your weakness is?
I'm very clumsy.
Okay, what message do you have for the newcomers, and DJ?
Yeah, so I will tell them, you know, like now there is internet, YouTube, mm-hmm. and even if you want to become like something, you just have to, like if you want to learn some skill, okay, you can just go on YouTube, search for it, you know, knowledge is free nowadays. Mm-hmm. So you can become anything you want.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Which are the key points or maybe one or two needed to become a successful DJ?
Be humble.
Mm-hmm. One.
And be humble and always like always be hardworking.
All right. Okay. Well played, Skeletron. Mm-hmm. Did you go ahead with you went through any questions earlier?
No.
To pass this?
No.
Okay. All right. Good job.
Thank you.
Moving on to DJ Jonathan. Are you ready?
Yeah, all good, yes.
Okay. Nervous system, sir?
Repeat.
All right. What one thing is the ugliest thing you've ever seen?
Nothing.
What's your favorite beverage?
Coke. I don't drink.
I know. Okay. Name a person who inspires you.
Tiesto.
Okay. What is one food you would never want to give up?
Chicken lollipop.
What was your first job?
A bartender.
What's the first concert you ever attended or performed?
It was in London for Carnival.
What was the last word you had to look up to see what it meant? Word. Google kelele?
No.
Do you recycle?
No.
Breakfast food or dinner food?
Breakfast.
What's your favorite type of music to play?
Afro.
How would you describe your typical performance style?
Actually, people should judge me, so I...
Are you fasting this length?
No. Sorry.
Okay, how do you interact with guests during the event?
Just nod your head and say yes for everything.
Okay, even if you are angry at them. Yeah. What kind of equipment do you use?
It's a controller XTJ XZ.
Your favorite or irritating colleagues?
No, there's no one.
Okay. No controversy. Okay, if you're putting together a music festival, who would you lined up besides you?
From Goan, definitely Skeleton. Mm.
And just because he's here?
No. Because I've seen many people, no issues, but I personally like him because he's down to earth and then because of his attitude.
Mm-hmm. All right, well played. And last but not the least, a straightforward question to you all. Tell us the places that you all have played music or occasions or which parties.
I played at Sunburn and... in UK I've played and Goa.
Of course the clubs.
Like, yeah,
Goa.
What about you?
Yeah, Goa only I've played in Kamaki and because I went to the UK so I couldn't get into any other clubs. In the UK I've played in Egg London, most of the clubs and yeah, that's it.
All right. Well played, Jonathan. Magas ta aaj tu homework karun yela. Baate dagu yata sa na ulai thela lagai mo.
Kena mani kira ulai thale.
All right. Well played. Now it's some fun time and now it's something called as read my lips.
Okay.
Not my lips. Each other's lips. So are you all ready for it?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's go ahead. All right. Read my lips with DJ Skeletron and DJ Jonathan. Are you all ready?
Yes.
Okay. So let's get started. Your time starts now.
Chod gormi zata. Chod.
Chod.
Gormi.
Gormi.
Zata.
Zata.
Okay, got it.
Good.
All right. Read it. And your time starts now.
Pav, omelet, kha.
Done?
Yeah.
Wow, man. How you can egg pie? That I'm doing. Nah. He is used to it.
Yeah.
All right. Okay. And the last cheat, yeah. You'll have to win, huh?
Yeah. Sure.
And your time starts now.
Disco. Disco. Disco nuts.
Yes. He guessed it. Oh, he guessed all three. All right, Jonathan. Teen guests tu khele already.
Aye.
Okay. So now it's your time. So are you ready? Okay. Let's see. Hope the best.
Yeah.
So here. You have 30 seconds. Read it. And your time starts now.
Tu. Dita. Tu ta. Tu dita. Tu. Yata.
Say it.
Tu. Kitya. Lost.
Okay. Finally, you guessed it, man. All right. Okay. Two more chances. All right. And your time starts now.
Nuts. Eyes. 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 Lebat. Lam. Eyes.
Guess it.
Eyes, eyes. Number. No, I can't.
All right. Ready? Anji ko baba tol ka dekhai. And your time starts now.
Tu. Kula.
Guess it.
Ula. U. Like. Urak. Urak pia.
Okay. All right. Well done, guys. Well played.
Okay.
Only thing, tu jiklo, to ek point aalo. All right. Anyways, well done. All right, it's time to say goodbye, adios. Thank you so much for coming here, giving us your precious time and letting us to take your interview. Thank you, thanks a lot.
Thanks Jonathan, for having us.
Kaldantan, diobore korumata kidyak. Tumcha moladik ved kadun tumhi angasor aile ani amka ek mulakat gyo ek sandhi dili mon kaldantan diobore korum. This is a small token of appreciation from the team Prudent Media. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
This is for you and this is for
thank
your skeleton.
You.
I know, read my lips was little bit tougher, but I enjoyed because you all were DJs and you all guessed it very quick.
Thank
Jonathan
you.
And Maso Harola to gaye. Okay? So we'll have to see that. Okay. Thank you so much. Tumka soglang, aichi karyabol poroitalang, sodan sod, dio bore koru. Poretrawat, Prudent Media chair, Candid with Candida. Oh.